Hello, dear ones, Father Peter John, coming to you from All Saints Orthodox Church in Bloomington, Indiana. Christ is in our midst. I want to talk today about the proto-martyr John Kochurov, who was a missionary priest who came to us from Russia back in 1895. He was a devout man who was renowned for his preaching and his teaching and other things that I'll talk about momentarily, but he requested to be sent as a missionary to America and was sent to St. Vladimir's Church in Chicago, which ultimately became Holy Trinity Cathedral. When he arrived there in Chicago with his dear wife, there was no church building for them. So they immediately undertook to begin to build one. They contacted the renowned architect, Louis Sullivan, who did an amazing job designing this church. If you've never been there, you should go. It is still there. The architecture is just so inspiring. You will be struck with awe when you see this beautiful little cathedral. It's gorgeous. Anyway, so he built this cathedral and was very active, not only at his own parish — he was well loved at his parish in Chicago — but also he was very active in starting other churches. He helped to build 6 other Orthodox churches in and around Chicagoland area, Buffalo, New York, etc. And so people looked to him for guidance and inspiration and help in their projects. And that was the kind of person he was. His desire was outreach. His desire was mission work on American soil. It's kind of exciting to think about missionaries coming here to bring the gospel and to bring the church to America. So thank God for people like Father John. Now, after 12 years of being in America, Father John was called back overseas. He served a parish in modern-day Estonia for 3 years, and then he was assigned to St. Catherine's Cathedral outside of St. Petersburg. That was 1916. He immediately became a very, very popular priest at that church because of his teaching and his preaching. The amount of skill that he had picked up in America with all of his teaching here, he brought that back, and people were so excited about it, so excited to learn the gospel and to learn about the church and the theology of the church and the teaching of the church. And Father John brought that fire with him, and he brought that that knowledge and that wisdom. So as I said, he was established then immediately at St. Catherine's Cathedral as a powerhouse of a preacher and a catechist, well loved by his people. But we know what happened shortly after 1916, and that is 1917, the Bolshevik Revolution. And Father John was there with his people praying as the Bolsheviks were violently beginning to take over in Russia. And Father John, his response, of course, to this kind of violence and upset and upheaval was prayer. And so the people came to the church, and he and the people were praying in the church, and then they were making processions around the church. And the Bolsheviks showed up, and they took Father John by force, and they brought him outside of the town, and he was martyred there for his faith in Christ and commitment to Christ in the church. So we have another American martyr, of course, in this case martyred not on American soil, but martyred there on Russian soil outside of St. Petersburg under the Bolsheviks. May St. John Kochurov pray unto God for us, that we too, with boldness of heart, with courage, may stand against those who place themselves in opposition to Christ, to his love, and to the church. May we be emboldened to be with Christ and for Christ at all times and in every hour, like St. John was, that example that he gave us, this St. John of Chicago, the first martyr of the Bolshevik Revolution. Christ is in our midst. He is and ever shall be.